I think that a search warrant was issued to look at the helicopter, his helicopter, which was used to transport many of the suspects after the fact. Nilikas sila mula sa Negros Oriental papunta sa Maguindanao. Ginamit yung chopper. Kaya ito ay inisuhan na warrant. Kaya isa yan sa mga nangyari itong nakaraang mga araw. Yan, isa yan sa mga bagay na mapapaniwala ka na meron siyang kinalaman. Kasi chopper niya mismo ang ginamit na sinakyan ng mga salarin upang makataka sila mula sa Negros Oriental kasi naka-checkpoint na lahat eh. Naka-checkpoint na lahat. Wala nang checkpoint, langit na lang eh. Kaya doon sila dumaan. Yun, nahanap na yung chopper. It's going to be taken into custody. Bale, we're trying to get a pilot. We wrote the PNP to provide us with a pilot so we can have the chopper under safekeeping of the Philippine National Police or the military in Cebu. We want the chopper to be brought to Cebu for safekeeping. Sa hangar niya, sa Dumaguete. Yes, pero ano na yun, parang wala nang marking nung tinanggal na nila yung marking nung napuntahan siya nung isang araw. Ano yan eh, transfers yan eh. Yung mga, ano tawag na?
Decal.
Decal, o kaya minsan yung pinapambalot. Yung pinapambalot ng wrap, minsan naka-wrap siya. Oh. You know, I really don't care about what he says because if he does not face the music, he doesn't deserve my time. Humarap siya. Salita siya ng salita. Nare-reveal lang yung pagka iba ng kanyang character. I don't want to use any words to describe that because I don't want to go into a verbal tussle with anybody.
So si Ambassador Loxin,
well, he's a good friend of mine. Ambassador Loxin is a very good friend of mine. We've been good friends for the longest time. Since 2004, magkaibigan na kami. I think the law is very clear. It does not take a genius to know that. It's really, the law has been there all along. It's just that probably because of the job that we have right now, we look into to what is available, what law is available to us, to be able to address the situation, because there are many laws that we can use to prosecute, but there are laws that are more up to the challenge or more appropriate for the time and for the circumstances surrounding the crimes committed. And I think the law is very clear. By now, I know that you've read the law. You've seen it. You read it one more time and you see that there will be new revelations to you about how the law works. Ano talaga yan? It's really, that was a long debated. I was a member of Congress and that was debated. I listened to the debates. Congressman Tevez was a member of that Congress also that debated the anti-terror law of 2020. We were both there. Of course, that was the time of the pandemic. But still, it's a law that went through the whole process of refinement because of the big debate that ensued when it was debated on the floor and even in committee in committee in Congress in the I think it was the Committee on Justice that and National Security. It was the joint committee that heard that. Affirmative, Ren. He voted for the bill, as I did. I voted for the bill. But the anti-terror law was a landmark legislation because it took the place of the Human Security Act. And it is a more complete law and it is a more fair law and more comprehensive law. The signals are not clear right now. It's really up to DJ Bantag to face the music or not. It's up to him. But as I say, the government has the ways and the means to find people who run away from the law, especially high-profile ones. Very hard to hide. Mas mahirap magtago yung mga high-profile na tao. Alam naman natin yon. It takes a lot of patience to be hiding from the law because it's a very lonely scenario there. Okay?
May gusto ko pa i-surprise ka.
Wala naman tayong surprises. As I told you before, that we were going to reveal something in the Senate, and we revealed it, that the anti-terror law was going to be used. And we'll be meeting with the Anti-Terror Council very soon, in the next few days. And we will be discussing it. With the Anti-Terror Council, the designation of Congressman Tevez as a terrorist, and some of the people who worked with him to be within the same, to have the same designation also. We're looking at three, four, or five other people who may be considered as part of the terror organization of Mr. Tevez. Not to my knowledge. But they played very pivotal roles in the plots that ensued and what happened to Governor Degamo. Remember, Governor Degamo was a governor of a province, the highest locally elected official in the country. And for that to be done to him took a lot of gumption, and that act alone instilled fear in most people in Negros Oriental. If they can do it to a governor, what more for other people who are ordinary people? I think that is one thing that we should remember. He was the highest elected local official. There are only 70 of them in the country. 74, I think, in the country. 74 ba? 74 governors, highest local officials in the country. And for that to be done to them was just incredible. It's just the gumption to do it took a different kind of person, a different kind of character, and probably a different kind of organization to do it. People who played different roles that we have defined in our investigation, who have been described to us in many ways as really involved in the process. But we're still working on some of the details about some of them, because not everything comes out immediately. We just have to work or keep working on it. So because this really entails a lot of patience. Kaya, when the senators asked if there's a warrant of arrest, there's none. But we will come up with it at the proper time. He will be part of it. Masama siya sa core group ng what the others call a terrorist cell. Kasama siya. I don't know. Parang wala pa akong alam, no? But we'll see. But there are really people who have been named and who are undergoing investigation now through the ways and means available to government to investigate these people.
Sir, in relation na rin sa terrorist financing, ang magiging facility yung involvement sa SDL and ISAB operations, is that part of our purview to investigate?
Well, call it terrorist financing. Terrorist financing. That's also part of the law. Hindi pa. I took the opportunity to rest, finally rest a bit over the weekend. It's a long weekend. And I just worked on a few papers nung weekend. I was not really going around with people. Ano lang ako. Very private time I spent.
So you mentioned terrorist financing. So if we're looking at STL or ESA Bombard?
Yes, that's where it will go now. The fact that this money is being used, was used to finance terrorism, should be one angle that we should follow as investigators, as people who were investigating a crime so dastardly. We haven't gotten to that yet. I just briefed him. Actually, I told him more than 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago that the anti-terror law was coming into play and that it was very possible for us to use it. I actually alerted the president about this already around 3 weeks ago because I knew it was going to come into play already when we were analyzing all the things that happened. Okay, thank you. Yes, but I know. Tomorrow we have to. I'm leaving. I will only be there at the opening. Maybe not even. I might follow after. I might follow to the oil spill meeting. But we have to talk about the SIM card registration problem. But my view there is really the law was there 6 months ago. It was really up to them to follow the law. And there will be a lot of repercussions, but the telco companies should not make it an opportunistic event. Dapat dyan, fair sila sa lahat. I don't know. I will have to talk to, in the meeting tomorrow, we will have to ask the cabinet cluster that will meet tomorrow.
So, sir, Malacanang kayo tomorrow?
I think so, yeah.
Wala pa.
I was given the agenda only this morning. So, well, the law is the law. We have to follow the law. It's, of course, the position of the DOJ.
Pero, sir, personally, you feel it should be extended?
I don't know. I do not want to posit any opinions on that matter. But I will only say that, di ba? Dura lex sed lex. The law may be harsh, but it is the law. So, if you want to wait for the last minute, there are repercussions. But of course, our eyes will be on the telcos not to take undue advantage of this. Kasi maraming ano yan, consequences, may mga disappearing load na naman yan, mayroong pera na naman sa GCash. Maraming consequences to. Kaya dapat fair dyan ang mga telco. Okay, thank you.